Last week on BYOB TV, the five remaining teams were tasked with creating working brew systems using nothing but a giant pile of junk. All the teams rose to the occasion, some more than others. There was ingenuity, creativity, and deceit.
You guys forgot this.
When it all shook out, it was 2.5 men who built the best system and Beer Hemorrhage who was sent packing.
You did well.
Now, the race is on. Who will be crowned champion brewer?
It's week five of Brew Your Own Beer Television, and we're out at Lagunitas Brewing Company in Petaluma, California. There are only four teams remaining after last week's difficult challenge, and it only gets harder. Welcome to BYOB TV.
1,000 years before there was bacon, 4,000 years before there was cultivated wine, and 8,000 years before there was Jesus, enterprising women were fermenting grains in jars. These mothers of invention were the creators of beer. And today, millions of people worldwide say thank you. 12,000 years later, 24 Bay Area homebrewers, beer lovers, and some folks who think making beer just sounds cool will test their knowledge of beer, challenge their brewing skills, and have a lot of fun. For 10 weeks, these homebrewers and beer geeks will compete for a trip to the Pilsner Urquell Brewery in Pilsen, Czech Republic. This is BYOB TV.
Teams, welcome to week four of BYOB TV, and congratulations on being one of only four teams remaining. Now, we've brought you to Lagunitas Brewing Company in Petaluma, California today for what is one of my favorite challenges of this show. You're going to be asked to replicate a Lagunitas beer. That's right, make an exact clone of one of these Lagunitas beers, and you can walk away with the win. To help you with your challenge and explain the beer, let me introduce Lagunitas brewmaster, Jeremy Marshall.
So gentlemen, today you are being challenged to brew Lagunitas New Dogtown Pale Ale. It is a West Coast style pale ale, aggressively hopped, and it has a very spicy, oily aroma.
Jeremy is one of the youngest master brewers in all of professional brewing. What he's talking about now is mostly of interest to brewers, but for the contestants, each word is critical.
Now, there are at least five of these malts in the recipe, and there are at least three of these hops in the boil. The only other piece of information that I can give you is that it has a dry hop bill of 1 pound per barrel.
Is that all we're giving them?
That's all I want to give them.
Good job. I know you've got questions for Jeremy and you want to try to get a little more information, but it's not going to be that easy. As always, let me introduce our director of difficulty, Jason Petros.
All right, first things first, there's a lot of information out on the internet about Lagunitas and their great beers. We're gonna make sure that you can't access that information. Justin, can you please collect their cell phones?
I can. Cell phones, get them out.
I hope no one else has this.
So what we've decided to do to figure out how many questions you're gonna be able to ask Jeremy, we've set up a relay style barrel race. First place winner gets to ask four yes or no questions. Second place asks three. Third place asks two. Now, if you notice, there's four teams. Well, the winner from last week do not have to race.
Yes.
And they will be with Jeremy listening to the answers of your questions.
So with the rules set and cell phones confiscated to keep any teams from getting an unfair advantage from the internet, Team Shamrockers is once again in JP's doghouse.
Here we go.
Team Shamrockers, can you guys please join me at your booth, Nate? So, as you know, we took your cell phones away.
It's true.
The point of that is to limit your access to outside information. It has come to my attention that you guys have a wireless router that you failed to mention. I would like to have that, please.
Sure.
And you all get spanked for cheating.
Well, no.
Yes?
We were told yesterday not to ask questions specifically, and we were told to give up our cell phones. And so we said, don't ask us these questions.
It is
said,
the...
Okay, so there, we didn't ask.
You can always ask questions.
Right, but we were told not to.
Ask for forgiveness, not for permission.
Exactly.
So you're going to make us work very hard to make sure that you're playing by the rules.
Absolutely.
Okay. Let's do a check real quick and just make sure. Okay. I have a router for sale. No, I'm kidding.
When we come back, true barrel racing, and Shamrockers will compete with a handicap. Welcome back to BYOB TV.
All right, teams, here we are at the barrel race course. The object is to run a relay race while rolling these barrels across the ground. Now, Team Shamrockers, you were caught breaking the spirit of the no cell phone rule, which was to eliminate any outside information. So for the first leg of your relay, the team member who's going first must carry this bottle of Lagunitas beer in their hands.
First. The old guy's going first?
Can I argue the fact that we're being penalized at all?
No. We found it goes against the spirit of the rule. I can tell Matt's very mad right now.
I'm not very mad, but I don't think we broke any spoken rule.
No, spirit.
We'll deal with it.
Thank
you. We can handle this.
Thank you.
We can handle this. Thank you, Jake.
All right, you guys ready? Glenn, even up a little bit there, Tiger. Come on, there we go. At the sound of the horn, you guys are gonna go. On your marks, get set.
Corey from the OGs apparently never saw a beer keg he didn't tap, and today was no different. Notice how Matt is having no difficulty working with a beer in his hand. This comes naturally to homebrewers.
Go, 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 buddy, go! Go!
Two-thirds of the way through the race, Shamrockers have a respectable lead.
Come on, guys, cheer your team on. Let's go!
You got it. Easy.
But in the home stretch, Tyler from the OGs gets in the zone and is pulling away with an easy victory. Uh-oh.
What's up, good?
What just happened? Who won?
I didn't even see it. I didn't even pay attention.
My flat bottom was down when his was up on the angle, so might have to go to the tape.
The finish of the race was so close, no one knew who won.
Well, he was the best individual.
Booyah.
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 We're not sure.
We had to literally go to the tape.
Coming up on the finish here. I'm seeing OG's pass, but keg down. There's the Simcoe's.
Yep. So the Simcoe's crossed the finish line before the OG's keg was down.
Was back down.
What?
And then the keg was not put back.
Simcoe's got it.
Simcoe's got it. Simcoe's came in first.
That's good tone.
Yeah.
All right, Team Simcoe, the OG's. We had to review the tape. Came down to the wire. Both of you guys did great.
But we do have a winner. Team Simcoe.
Yay! Nice.
Yeah,
so the OGs concede, and Simcoe will have the extra questions to ask of Brewmaster Jeremy Marshall. All that and more when we come back. Fire! Fire! Welcome back to Brew Your Own Beer TV.
We're here in the Lagunitas tasting room with last week's winner, Team 2.5 Men. We have Dave, Brian, and Brian. They're gonna get to ask two yes or no questions of the Lagunitas brewmaster, Jeremy Marshall. They also get to listen in on all the other team's questions today. So guys, you're gonna hear 11 answers about New Dogtown Pale Ale.
As 2.5 Men are feeling high and mighty knowing they'll have 11 answers about what makes Lagunitas New Dogtown Pale Ale taste like it does, the OGs are forming an alliance with Shamrockers.
I mean, let's be honest. We're all trying to win here, all this red team, other blue team.
You want
to
collaborate? We're down with it.
We can share our information. I don't think that's against the rules or anything like that. Nobody said anything against that.
No, I agree.
We can always ask Justin.
Yeah, for sure.
They never did.
I think we should conglomerate our questions and get more information out of it.
Okay. So the plan for the OGs and Shamrockers is to pool their questions and share information. The goal is to take out 2.5 Men.
You have two yes or no questions to ask Jeremy. Please go ahead.
Are there Amarillo hops in the beer?
Yes.
Jeremy, are there oats used in this beer?
No.
Thank you.
Those are good questions, guys.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, well done, guys. Now we're gonna bring in the other teams. You have to stay silent, and you may listen to the rest of the answers. Good luck, Team 2.5.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Team Simcoe, you have four yes or no questions for Jeremy. Please go ahead.
Hey, question one. Do you use crisp amber in the beer?
No.
Number two, do you use Centennial as a flavor or aroma hop?
No.
Number three, do you use Cascade as a flavor or aroma hop?
No.
And number four, do you use CTZ as a flavor or aroma hop?
No.
Pretty good.
Team OGs, you have three yes or no questions for Jeremy. Please go ahead.
Is there more than one hop varietal in the dry hop?
Yes.
Is there more than four malt varieties, barley malt varieties in the mash?
Yes.
Is there more than one adjunct by varietal or process in the mash?
No.
Team Shamrockers, you have two yes or no questions for Jeremy. Please go ahead.
Are there more than four malt varieties in the mash?
Yes.
Is there Citra?
No.
Well done, guys. That's all you get.
Thanks very much.
As soon as they'd asked their last question, Shamrockers was off to implement their diabolical scheme.
We started with... told us there was five from the beginning. Why did we have to do even four?
We already knew.
Doesn't matter now.
That's what Matt just said.
You're supposed to five.
More than 4 months.
Five.
Within five.
I said we already asked that one.
What a tangled web we weave.
So guys, do you think you got any special advantage out of getting the 11 questions?
Yes. We got the most special advantage. This is amazing.
This is awesome.
Enough information to clone this beer?
I think we're the only ones that really know what hops are in this beer, Justin.
Okay. Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
And so the brewing begins. Each team using what little information they have to try and clone a brand new beer and win this week's competition. When we come back, Lagunitas Brewmaster Jeremy Marshall is the sole judge of who will come closest to recreating his beer. Welcome back to Brew Your Own Beer TV. We're back in the Lagunitas tasting room. Our teams have taken their beers home, fermented them, and dry hopped them, brought them back for our brewmaster Jeremy Marshall to taste and decide who has the best clone and who's going home. This is team number one's beer.
Yeah, I would say these guys probably nailed the bitterness. They got one of the aroma hops. They missed it on the handling of the fermentation. They missed it on the malt bill, and it seems as if they also might have mashed in too hot. It's overall way too sweet.
This is team number two's beer.
In terms of the aroma, I mean, these guys did a pretty good job. I'd say they got real close. Flavor's good too.
Do you get any diacetyl out of it?
There is a skosh, not a metric skosh, but a...
All right, fair enough.
This is team number three's.
You know, I just can't help but have that thought swimming around in the back of my head that this could be the kitchen sink guys, because if you put everything in, you kind of get everything out.
Right.
And sometimes in everything, you get nothing. And this has got a whole lot of nothing.
All right, guys, here's our last beer, beer number four.
This beer could have fermented too hot, perhaps, leading to some of those pineapple-y apple flavors. Those would be, esters, things like this, fruity flavors.
A lot of pineapple.
There's a lot of pineapple in this beer.
It almost pricks my tongue. It's so pineapple-y.
Oh, yeah.
Jeremy, you do need to rank them.
Okay.
If you need to try again, there's more beer.
Yeah, I would. I mean, since I am sending somebody home, I mean, we have our thoughts about who that might be, but...
I'm out.
You tell me who you want to try.
Notice
again.
The guy coming up to me and whispering something in my ear? Well, that's our producer, who's decided it's time to really test our judges' abilities. So when Jeremy asks to retry some of the beers, we secretly let him judge the real thing, Lagunitas New Dogtown Pale Ale.
Here's number four, Jeremy.
I don't remember one being that clear.
Man knows his beer.
Well done, you didn't even taste it.
After a few more minutes, Jeremy has decided which team was the closest beer to Lagunitas and which beer will send one team home.
All right, teams, welcome back to the Lagunitas tasting room. We've given your beers to brewmaster Jeremy Marshall, the man who invented the beer that you were challenged to clone. He's tasted them and decided who will stay and who will go home. OGs, Jeremy did not like your kitchen sink approach to this recipe. He thought you took a whole lot of ingredients, threw them all into one beer, and hoped for the best. Jeremy, what did you like about their beer?
I gotta say, you guys nailed the IBU almost perfectly. And in your dry hop character, you did achieve a kind of nice melon note that I found pleasant. And though it's not the New Dogtown, it had merit in its own right, so.
OGs, congratulations, you're staying around to the next episode.
Yeah! Woo!
You're our third runner-up.
You were just that far from being eliminated. Team 2.5 Men. Despite having more information than any of the other teams, Jeremy found that your beer was not fermented well and was full of diacetyl. Thought you fermented cold. Jeremy, is there anything that you liked about this beer?
I gotta say, as your sample sat out and we drank it and it warmed up, it began to taste better and better. And the true technical prowess, your brewing skills began to jump out.
That being said, 2.5 Men, you're our second runner-up. You're moving on to the next week. Good job, guys. And that leaves us to our final two teams of this episode. One of you made the best beer here. One of you made the worst beer here. So one gets to stay with an advantage going into next week, and the other one is eliminated from the show entirely. Team Shamrockers. Again, Jeremy didn't like the kitchen sink approach to the beer. Too many ingredients left it muddled. He also couldn't find the hops. Is there anything that you liked about this beer, Jeremy?
One thing I can say about your beer is that you pretty much beat out all the other teams in your fermentation management. In other words, you guys had the least amount of diacetyl in your beer.
Congratulations. Team Simcoe. Way too much specialty malt. Us homebrewers know that too much specialty malt can really ruin a great beer. You can do everything else right and make it taste pretty bad by overdoing it on a sweet malt. Is there something that you liked about this beer, Jeremy?
I gotta say about tasting y'all's beer is that the mash temperature that you guys selected, you guys nailed it because the residual sweetness and the overall dryness of your beer was perfect.
Congratulations. Now it's time to find out who goes home. Team Shamrockers, you will not be joining us next week. I'm sorry. Congratulations to Team Simcoe. You made the best beer this week. The closest clone to New Dogtown Pale Ale. Yeah.
Congratulations, you guys.
Gentlemen.
Awesome.
Cheers.
Right.
Good job.
We knew you were the team to beat. We really did.
Yeah, we were.
Absolutely.
Team Simcoe, there wasn't just one thing about your beer that Jeremy liked. You brewed the closest clone to Lagunitas New Dogtown Pale Ale this week. Jeremy, would you like to tell them why it was the best beer?
Pretty much right off the bat, there's an old saying at Lagunitas, we say the nose knows. As soon as the scent of your beer greeted my nostrils, something very familiar happened. And I said, wow, these guys got the aroma hops, which is the soul that inhabits a fresh beer. And the choices made, I think you guys nailed it.
And there you have it. It was a tough challenge, and I think at least in this particular case, the best brewers won this week's episode. Congratulations, and we'll see you all next week.
Thanks.
Good job.
Next week on BYOB TV, making beer is one thing. Cooking with beer is something else.
I will not make this easy for you.
And that's exactly what our three remaining teams will be up against. I'm Justin Crosley. We'll see you next week.
It's been a lot of fun and have enjoyed our time here. I think I speak for all of my team when I say that.
I'm proud of my team. I'm proud of how we performed. And I learned so much through these four episodes.
It's been tremendous. It's been wonderful.